So what I have here is the Wooting 60HE keyboard, and it's essentially deemed one of the most pay-to-win keyboards in gaming because of its Gateron Likert switches and its Hall effect sensors. The keyboard utilizes magnets to create analog input in a keyboard, similar to how joysticks in a controller work. And so it basically allows you to customize the actuation point on a key-per-key basis. And this is incredibly useful for games like Valorant, Osu, Overwatch, or basically any game that requires any form of rapid input. So using the Wootility software, you can customize the actuation point to be as little as 0.1 millimeters to as much as bottoming out, which is 0.4 millimeters. And what I want to do is mod the keyboard so that it looks better, sounds better, feels better, and is hopefully overall a better keyboard. I have to admit, the keyboard stock already feels pretty good to use, but there definitely is still room for improvement. And I'm building this keyboard as a gift, and so I just hope to document my process with building it and modding it today. Alright, so I opted for the Mechanisk Club T. So this is the case I'm going to be using. It's the Mechanisk Club T. So this is how the switch works. There's a magnet on the bottom. Oh, it's probably not in focus, but magnet on the bottom, and then I think on the PCB there's a sensor to detect the magnet. Which is pretty cool. Okay, so now all the switches have been removed, so I'm gonna remove the stabilizers. Okay, so my footage cut out on accident, but basically I just unscrewed the PCB and it exposed the plate film. And these are the plate mounted stabs. Okay, so now my Wooting is completely disassembled. I think I'm gonna lube and holee mod the stabilizers first, then I'll lube the switches, and then add foam and tape mod. Oh, and the switch films and pads. Okay, well first I'm gonna lube and tune these stabilizers and Bandaid mod them. So funny story, I actually, when trying to wash these stabilizers, because they come factory lubed, I accidentally washed away a stabilizer stem down my sink drain. So now I bought these Duroc plate-mounted stabilizers. I'm gonna just use these, which is kind of silly of me. But, you know, it happens. Yeah, so I tried to holee mod the old ones, but because they were so lubed, or I think it was because they were lubed, I can't tell if it's because the adhesive on this is bad or it's because they were lubed. But I'm gonna try again. And if not, I think I'm just gonna not holee mod. Oh yeah, this definitely sticks more. So yeah, it's honestly probably because of the lube, bruh.
New York.
I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep. No one should, I might kill my ex. Not the best idea, his new girlfriend's next. How I get here. We got this last one to do. I can't focus it, but this is the last one. You know, I'm not pretty good at this. It's the routine. Alright, lube time.
Next, we lube the stabilizer housing. My preferred lube of choice for this step is Krytox 205 grain.
Alright, so I'm lubing the wires now with Krytox XHT BDZ, and then I lube the housings with 205 grade 0. So yeah, I finished the spacebar here. Now I just gotta do the rest. Alright, second one down, three more to go. Okay, all the stabilizers are lubed now, so I can close this. Lubing my first switch right now. And then lube the spring. Alright, first switch lubed. Look, you can kind of hear the sound differences. I'll show the mic. So this is lubed. Unlubed. Lubed. Unlubed. I'm talking trips to Puerto Rico. Say the word and we go. You can be my flicka. Girl, I'll be your flicka. Mamacita, I ain't never make a promise that I can't keep. I promise that your smile ain't gonna never be. 1 a.m. Eyes closed, I'm slowly falling. To the music and the atmosphere. Now and then I feel life fading softly all over me as I remember last year when I was alone in my bed. Unhappy thoughts in my head and living silently inside. Okay, I'm living the spoons right now. But you're always on your phone, always on your phone. No gravity, okay, no honesty, no ashes for my enemies. No honesty, no honestly, okay. Nice. Alright, so all my switches are lubed, and then these two are lubed too. I just kind of messed up the springs and I couldn't bother to fix it. Because when I bag lubed the springs, like, some of them got intertwined. And then I tried pulling some of the springs away and they, like, warped. And I was just like, whatever. Okay. So now I need to switch pads on and then I'm done. Oh no, and then Tempest mod. And then I'm done. And then keycaps. And then I'm done. process of doing the Tempest mod. I think I'm gonna do 3 layers of tape. Okay, I switched to my phone for recording because my camera keeps overheating and it runs out of storage and I just don't want to deal with it right now. The GMK Maestro set, because the person I'm building this for is a musician, so I thought this was very fitting. Hey, so just a quick editor's note here. I want to say that overall, I'm pretty happy with how the build turned out. Besides the two switches with warp springs, I think that the keyboard felt really nice, sounded way better than it did stock, and overall just looks better too. I will say that the keys with stabilizers turned out a bit mushier than I would have liked. Like if you saw in my typing demonstration, the shift key was pretty slow to come up, or at least slower than I think it should have been. And I think this was because I used a heavier lube on the stabilizer wires, the Crytox XHT BDZ, and I decided to holee mod them. So if you're going to replicate my mods and you choose to use a heavier lube on the stabilizer wires like I did, then don't holee mod them. However, if you're sticking with a lighter lube on the wires like the Crytox 205 Grade 0 or even dielectric grease, then holee modding is probably worth it. I'll put all the parts I used and the mods I did in the description, but thank you for watching. This was really fun to make, and I hope that you are able to have success modding your Wooting as well.